Whenever you're feeling tired and need a lift, I suggest you try miso soup. Miso is known as a vegetarian yogurt. It is highly alkaline and has enzymes which aid digestion. For this vegetarian miso soup, we're using the 5 cups of vegetarian dashi, 4 to 5 tablespoons of miso of any kind, 2 cups of shredded Chinese cabbage known as wombok, a handful of bean shoots, a 10 centimeter strip of wakame sea vegetable which has been soaked for 10 minutes, or if you have wakame flakes, then 3 tablespoons of them soaked for a few minutes, some chopped spring onions, and 1/2 cup of tofu cubes. Once the wakame has been soaked for 10 minutes, we want to remove the stem and chop it up into small pieces. If you've bought wakame flakes, then you don't need to do this. Chop them up as finely as you can. To the vegetarian dashi stock, add the sliced cabbage and a handful of bean shoots and simmer this for a few minutes. While the soup is simmering, to the miso soup bowl, add the drained chopped wakame, some sliced spring onions and a few tofu cubes. And finally, it's time to add the miso paste. Take some of the hot stock and place it in a jug, and then add the miso paste to this stock and stir it up before we add it back into the soup. Once this has been well mixed, add it to the soup pot and continue to simmer for a few more minutes. Never boil miso because the enzymes and nutrients will be destroyed. Then ladle the miso soup into the prepared soup bowls. If you are making a large pot of dashi, then only add the miso to the amount you are eating at one sitting. Bringing the bowl to your mouth using chopsticks and slurping is definitely acceptable when enjoying your miso soup. Aside from being high in protein and low in fats, a great benefit of using tofu is that it's bland and so absorbs any flavour very well. Packaged tofu keeps for 3 to 4 weeks, so check the use-by dates. Once open, cover the tofu in water and change this water every day for 4 to 5 days. If you see a pink tinge to the tofu, then definitely throw it out. The recipe requires 400 grams of tofu, 4 tablespoons of shiro white miso, 2 tablespoons of whole tahini, 2 tablespoons of soaked wakame sea vegetable, 1 tablespoon of lemon juice, or you can use 1 tablespoon of brown rice vinegar. Before I start, blanch the tofu in boiling water for a few minutes and add 3 or 4 tablespoons of water to dilute the miso. So now I'm going to place all the ingredients into the blender. Drain the tofu first. Just cut it up a little bit. Add the dissolved miso. Add tahini. Wakame flakes. It doesn't matter if you get a little bit of the soaking water in there as well. And the juice of one lemon. All you have to do now is give it a whirl. Now the tofu dip is ready to serve. And I'm serving this with some brown rice crackers. People often ask me what I eat for breakfast, and I recommend a variety which can include miso soup, millet porridge, or even whole grain toast with tahini and miso. I also enjoy scrambled tofu, and this is a very simple to prepare recipe and it tastes great on whole grain toast. For the recipe, include 4 to 5 cups of dried shiitake mushrooms. These have been already cooked for about 10 minutes. And a quarter cup of the soaking water has been retained. You can also use fresh shiitake mushrooms. 400 grams of tofu. This is in boiling water. And then there's a quarter teaspoon of turmeric, 1 tablespoon of shoyu or tamari, or you can use a tablespoon of diluted shiro miso, 1 cup of grated carrot, 1/2 cup of chopped parsley, 1 tablespoon of wakame flakes. Or this is a beautiful shake made from sesame seed and nori sea vegetable, and 3 tablespoons of chives and a little bit of unrefined sesame oil. Firstly, blend the tofu with the turmeric and the shoyu for a few minutes. Add the shiitake water or a little bit of water to the tofu mix. And now heat the wok. Add a little bit of unrefined sesame oil to it. And then saute the sliced shiitake mushrooms for a few minutes. If you like to use onions, you can add them now. And it's time to add the tofu mix. Give that a stir, reduce the flame. And then add grated carrots. And the chopped parsley. And you can sprinkle in some of the sesame and nori shake. And finally, add some chopped chives. And this is quick and easy to prepare scrambled tofu. Almost looks like eggs. Here's another great quick to prepare recipe using tofu. The ingredients are 250 grams of tofu, which has been soaked in boiling water and drained, 1 chopped onion, 1 cup of shredded carrot, 2 celery stalks diced, 2 cups of organic brown rice or organic millet, or a combination of both, 1 tablespoon of miso mixed with 1 tablespoon of mustard and a little hot water, 1/2 to 1 cup of falafel mix. This falafel mix is a little bit spicy. It's made from broad beans and chickpeas, and it's gluten-free. It's available in health food stores. And a little bit of sesame oil. Firstly, place the tofu in a clean cotton cloth to drain the excess water. I suggest you use a chopping board and keep it here for about 5 to 10 minutes. Then pour a little bit of sesame oil into the wok and saute the onions for a few minutes. Now add the other vegetables, celery, and shredded carrots. If you don't like using sesame oil, try using olive oil or sunflower oil. Place the cooked rice into a mixing bowl. And crumble in the drained tofu. Draining tofu in this way makes it better for frying. And it's really a hands-on job here, as you can see. Then add the sautéed vegetables. Add the miso mustard mix. And half a cup of the falafel mix. You can add more if you'd like it more spicy. Mix all these ingredients together. I find it easier to use my hands, so I'll just wet them a little bit. Quite sticky. Before making the burgers, make sure that the mixture has been cooled. I prefer to grill the burgers, but you can roast or fry or bake. And place them onto a lightly oiled baking tray. This recipe makes 10 to 12 burgers, and now I'm going to grill them. The tofu burgers are ready to eat. Serve them with your favourite topping, such as miso pesto sauce. Aduki beans are native to China and Korea, but are now grown organically in America and Europe. These small little red beans, which are known in Japan as the king of the beans, are said to be good for the liver and the kidneys. In traditional Chinese medicine, aduki beans are said to help detoxify the body. They act as a diuretic, are lower in fat than other beans, and the great news is that they help promote weight loss. For the aduki bean and pumpkin dish, use half a cup of soaked arame sea vegetable and retain the soaking water, 1 cup of pre-soaked aduki beans, and here I've used 5 centimeter strip of kombu with a soaking, 3 cups of filtered water, 4 cups of chopped pumpkin, and because it's organic, I've left the skin on it. This also holds a lot more nutrition and fiber, and shoyu and tamari to taste. Like lentils and other light beans, aduki beans don't really need to be soaked, but I suggest for better digestibility that you soak them for 2 to 5 hours with a strip of kombu. Remember that the kombu helps to break down the tough fibres of the beans and makes them more digestible, and also the minerals in the kombu help to balance out the protein and the oils in the beans. For the recipe, place the kombu in the bottom of the saucepan. Add the aduki beans and the water. Bring it to a boil and then simmer for 30 minutes. While cooking, you might need to add a little bit more water, but don't stir the beans because this will disrupt the cooking process. When the beans are tender, add in the chopped pumpkin and make sure that there's enough water to cover it. Then put the lid back on and simmer for another 20 minutes or until the pumpkin has been cooked. During the last 10 minutes of cooking, add the pre-soaked arame and soaking water. After the 10 minutes is up, mix the ingredients together and add shoyu or tamari to taste. The dish is now ready to serve. For those people who are very busy and haven't got time to cook the aduki beans, you can buy organic aduki beans that have already been cooked. Great aroma. Here is aduki pumpkin stew. Beetroots contain vitamin A and C, potassium and other minerals, while the tops contain vitamin A, calcium and iron. I really love using the tops in stir fry, it's delicious. Beetroots help to build and tone up the blood. A very helpful drink is carrot juice with a little bit of beetroot. But don't drink beet just on its own because it can create nausea from the intense cleansing reaction. My cooking style has been inspired by imagination, experience and mentors in vegetarian cuisine. One of them is Mary Estella. Her red velvet soup is rich in colour, nutrition and is especially flavoursome. The recipe uses red lentils. These are easy to digest, very low in fat and contain magnesium, vitamin A and B. The ingredients are 1 cup of red lentils, these have been washed and drained, 1 chopped onion, 1 tablespoon of sesame oil, 2 chopped carrots, 2 to 3 beetroots which have been scrubbed and chopped, 1 strip of kombu sea vegetable, 3 bay leaves, 6 cups of water, 2 to 3 tablespoons of dark miso and 1 dash of plum vinegar. Heat the oil in the pot, add the onion and sauté for 5 minutes. After the onions have been sautéed for 5 minutes, they're nice and translucent now, add the rest of the ingredients. Lentils, carrots, beetroots, the kombu, bay leaves, and the water. Bring slowly to the boil. This might take about 5 minutes. Once it's boiling, then use the flame tamer and simmer for 1/2 hour to 3/4 of an hour until the vegetables and lentils are very soft. You can use the lid for this as well. Once the lentils and vegetables are soft, it's time to blend it. Remember to remove the bay leaves but keep in the kombu. Now that it's been blended, it's time to add the miso. Add in half a cup of boiling water so that you can easily dissolve the miso. And add this to the soup. And finally, add a few drops of plum vinegar. This will give it a lovely tart flavour. Blend the ingredients together. The red velvet soup is ready to serve. And for garnish, you can use chopped parsley. And for an Italian flavour, try using basil, oregano, or rosemary.